Stop. tonight because I learned faith from what Ben Fitzgerald was talking about, a praying mother. And one night, I was in my room, and we were in the middle of a situation about to be evicted. A lot of you know my story, been homeless before, but we were about to be evicted, and I heard my mom crying in the middle of the night, and I wondered what was up, so I got up out of my bed, and I went over to her room, and I thought she was, you know, going through something, something was wrong. And so the door was cracked and I pushed it open just to see what was wrong with mom. And the crying that I heard wasn't the kind of crying that I thought it was. She was kneeling next to the bed, thanking God for his faithfulness. Even though she may not see the situation changing, she was declaring, God, you're still good. And I thank you for what we do have. We may not have all that we've been asking for, but we thank you that we have everything that we need because we have you, Jesus. And I declare,
the nature of Jesus.
See at your work, even when I don't feel you working.
We don't sing things over and over because we don't know what to do, though sometimes we do. We sing this over and over because you and I, we were meant for eternity. And for all of time, the angels and the elders have been singing holy and holy, and Jesus never gets tired of the same song. We're the ones who get tired. We're the ones who move on more quickly than he's ready to. And in these moments, sometimes we have to press past the temporary to press into the eternal mindset we were born for. And so we sing it again and again to remind ourselves of the nature of Jesus. This is our God. The one who makes streams flow in the desert. The one who brings you shade in the sun. The one who covers you with his wings and lets you hide in his shadow. Who lets you rest while he wars for you. This is who he is. Sometimes we sing it because we're sure, and sometimes we sing it until we know. But nonetheless, we sing it anyways. We sing of the nature of our God. It doesn't get old. That is who you are. That is who you are. That is who you are. One more time. That is who you are. It's who you've always been.
Darkness, we were made without hope, without light. Till from heaven you came running, there was mercy in your eyes. To fulfill the law and prophets, to a virgin came the word. From a throne of endless glory, to a cradle in the dirt.
You saw to the other side, knowing this was our salvation. Jesus, for our sake you died. Praise the Father. God of glory. In the moment that you rose, all of heaven held its breath, till that stone was moved for good, for the Lamb had conquered death. And the dead rose from their tombs, and the angels stood in awe, for the souls of all who'd come to the Father are restored. And the church of Christ was born, then the Spirit lit the flame. Now this gospel truth of all shall not kneel and shall not faint. By His blood and in His name, in His freedom I am free. For the love of Jesus Christ, who has resurrected me.
All thy works shall praise thy name in earth. And You call me out upon the waters, the great unknown, where feet may fail. And there I find you in the mystery, in oceans deep, my faith will stay. And I will call upon your name and keep my eyes above the waves. When oceans rise, my soul will rest in your embrace, for I am yours and you.
And I know, though the winter is long,
harvest it brings. Though my waiting prolongs even greater, your promise for me like a seed. I believe that my season will come. Lord, I think of your love like the low winter sun. As I gaze, I am blinded in the light of your brightness. Like a fire to the snow, I'm renewed in your warmth. Melt the ice of this wild soul till the pairing is beautiful. And I know, though the winter is long, even richer, the harvest it brings. Though my waiting prolongs even greater, your promise for me like a seed. I believe I can see the promise, I can see the future. You're the God of seasons, and I'm just in the winter. If all I know of harvest is that it's worth my patience, then if you're not done working, then God, I'm not done waiting. You can see my promise, even in the winter, 'cause you're the God of greatness, even in a manger. You take your time. You could have saved just in a second. Instead, you send a child. Though the winter is long, even richer, the harvest it brings. Though my waiting prolongs even greater, your promise for me. I believe that my season will come. And when I finally see my tree, still I believe there's a season to come. Like a seed you were sown for the sake of us all, from Bethlehem soil grew Calvary Sequoia.
Keep fighting voices in my mind that say I'm not enough. Every single lie that tells me I will never measure up. Am I more than just the sum of every high and every low? Remind me once again just who I am, because I need to know. failure, God, you have every victory.
Yeah.
Thank you, Lord.
beskåda som du har skapat med ditt allmaktsord. Där är din visdom väver livets trådar och alla väsen mättas vid ditt ord. Då brister själen ut i lovsångs ljud. O stora Gud, o stora Gud. Då brister själen ut i lovsångs ljud.
The Son of God was born in darkness. Give him praise.
Coming on. Here I am, down on my knees again, surrendering, oh, surrendering, oh. Find me here, Lord, as you draw me near, desperate for you. Desperate for you, and I surrender. Drench my soul as mercy and grace unfold, I hunger and thirst, I hunger and thirst. With arms stretched wide, I know you hear my cry. Speak to me now, Lord, speak to me.
Oh, Thy faithfulness. Great are you, Lord, for you reign above all the earth, above all every nation, above every tongue we say.
You give life, you are love, you bring life to the darkness, you give hope, you restore every heart that is broken. Great are you, Lord. It's your breath in our lungs, so we pour out our praise, pour out our praise. It's your breath in our lungs. Give life, you are love, you bring life to the darkness, you give hope, you restore every heart that is broken. Great are you, Lord. It's your in our lungs, so we pour.
It's who I am.
It's who I am. It's who I am.
You're a perfect Father. We are sons. We are daughters of the perfect Father. Perfect Father. You're a good, good Father. The sons and daughters of the good, good Father. You're perfect Father. You're good, good Father. You're sons and daughters of the good, good Father. Perfect Father. You're good, good Father. You're sons and daughters of the good, good Father. Yeah. Great are you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, because you are great, you are worthy, you're above every other name, and you are a father to the fatherless. Every son, every daughter has a father, and it's you. It's you who adores us. It's you who loves us. It's you who longs for us. It's you who seeks us, Father, because your ways are perfect. And we delight in them. Great are you, my Father.
Just begin to bless him in the spirit all over the room. Come on. Just for about 30 seconds, begin to minister to the Lord. That's right, sing in the spirit, all over the room.
Hallelujah for the cross. the cross.
Should I just focus on Jesus tonight? Let's pray in our hearts today. Truly, oh God, there's nothing we want more but you.
I need you more.
From the front to the back, to the left to the right. Just open up your hearts to Him. There's an open heaven over our church. In this service especially. In a few hours will be the end of this year, end of 2016, the most challenging year of our entire history. But God is with us. God is with you. God is for you. Give Him the highest praise tonight. Give Him the highest worship tonight. Just recently, one of my intercessors from Korea, who's actually living in America, just sent me this prophetic word. But I really believe it's for our church. So the husband wrote it in Korean, and then it was translated in English. It says, City Harvest Church, I'm going to paraphrase it to City Harvest. It says, when this season comes, you're going to come into a new season of God's presence. And His presence will be more real, and it will be a beginning of a totally new thing, new beginning. And I believe that 2016 is a time of preparing for the next season that will come to you. I saw how you've been wearing a strong armor of the truth of God, something that's much more stronger than what you have experienced in the past. God will heal your inner man in a deeper way. Because so much challenge that 2016 has caused you, I've seen how Jesus is wiping away the pain from your head and your hurting body, wherever you are hurt in yourself, with His cloth that has His blood on them. He was wiping your painful places with His own blood. I saw Jesus calling you into your greater purpose. And this challenging time that He's allowing you to go through is because God is saying, I will do even something that's greater in the future. So my children, please endure. Please win. Please stand firm. I will release a bigger heart to you and a bigger love to you. So wait for this time. In this coming year, Philippians 3 verse 20, for our citizenship is in heaven, from which we also eagerly wait for the Savior, the Lord Jesus Christ. I believe that in the future you will live in the heavenly realm, even more so than you live on the earthly dimension. I see that your heavenly reality will be even more real to you than your earthly realities. This is a season when the heaven is so much closer to you than the earth, and Jesus is closest to you than ever before. God is training you, City Harvest Church, to open your eyes even more, for you to live out the heavenlies on this earth even more so. And I believe that to win this situation, it's not just a battle that's in the earthly realm, but you live as if your heart and your soul and your thoughts are residing in heaven, while your physical body is here on earth. Romans 5 verse 2, through whom also we have access by faith into this grace in which we stand and rejoice in the hope of the glory of God. And not only that, but we also glory in tribulations, knowing that tribulation produces perseverance, and perseverance character, and character hope. Now hope does not disappoint, because the love of God has been poured out in our hearts by the Holy Spirit who was given to us. Let's just give God a big clap of praise. I believe we are coming into a new season. God's presence, God's power. Oh, God's reality is going to be more real than the earthly dimension. God is taking us into a supernatural realm in 2017. Come on, let's give Him praise tonight. Let's give God the highest praise. Hallelujah. About 6 hours, it's going to be 2017. How many of you are glad that we're going to come into the new year stronger than ever before? They're coming into something greater, something deeper. It's going to be the best year yet in all our lives. If you believe that, give the Lord a big clap of praise.